Mr. Violin stood by the shoreline under the northern lights, knowing that tomorrow was the big day when he would get to fulfill his lifelong dream to leave his small village and explore the world. He dreamed and sang of his upcoming adventures until the thoughts lulled him to sleep. He was awakened by his best friend, Mr. Viola, who would be making the journey with him. The two hurriedly got ready and made their way to the dock to board the ship. The ship set sail, and the two met Mrs. Cello, an older sailor who showed them the ropes around the mast.
Hello,
The village grew smaller in the distance and the open horizon more vast. The ship's crew working day and night to steer the boat in the right direction, each playing a vital part. Mr. Bass, Mrs. Flute, Mrs. Bassoon, Mrs. Horn, and Mr. Guitar. As they sailed for weeks, the three, Mr. Violin, Mr. Viola, and Mrs. Cello, became close friends and enjoyed the adventure of the waves and the infinite nature of the sea. Every night, Mr. Violin sang himself to sleep on the boat by looking toward the night sky. Finally, one day land was spotted afar. The captain ordered Mr. Violin, Mr. Viola, and Mrs. Cello to be the first to go ashore. As the three wandered deeper and deeper into this new land, they became very lost. Bugs and animals stirred behind bushes and trees as the three became unable to find their way back to their rowboat on the beach. Big green locusts buzzed around their heads. Hundred-pound cats stalked them behind the bark. Becoming slightly scared, the three ran farther into the woods until they met a group of tall men whose dress and hair looked unlike anything they had ever seen before. The three stood still as the men disappeared behind the trees, baffled not only by the different style of the men, but also by the question of whether or not these men were hostile. As the sun set, the three found a place to sleep for the evening, hoping rest would help in the search for the shore tomorrow. However, the tall trees blocked Mr. Violin's sight of the sky, and without his daily muse, the sky, he could not sing himself to sleep. So he wandered off to find a clearing in the trees. As he walked, he caught wind of sounds he'd never heard before. Quickly ran to awaken the others, and the three followed the sound through the forest. As they followed the sound, the noise grew greater. Sound led them to the shore, their rowboat, and the same group of men from earlier joined by friends. These men all sang a song to the sea, similar to how Mr. Violin sang to the sky. Mr. Violin, Mr. Viola, and Mr. Cello joined in with the singing. The music became so grand that even those from the ship joined in from the distance. Realizing they were not so different from one another, the mixed group sang and sang to the sky and the sea, the music floating across the waves and dancing into the wind until it rose and awakened the sun, who peeked her head out from over the horizon, shining brighter and more colorful than ever before.
Thank you.